voice of Dr. D. David Schultz, indeed, no. But a moment from now, we will hear the voice of Dr. D. David Schultz inviting us in to his home in Nashville, Tennessee.
Hey, hello. Yeah. Yeah, y'all come on in here. Y'all come on in. How y'all doing today? Kids, come on. Y'all get back in here in the living room. Got the TV station coming in here. Yeah, y'all just come on in and bring it. Hey, woman, come on in here. Yeah, this TV station, they're going to do a special on me. They want to see just how the doctor really is when he's at home. Well, yeah, y'all. Cameras, just give me a little room.
Okay, how's that?
Yeah, I'm glad y'all can make it out here today, because everybody you know is always talking about Dr. D, how crazy he is. And when y'all come to me, you boys better shut up over there now, hold it down. And I mean it too. Do you got any manners? Well, what's wrong with them kids? You know, I'm going a whole lot. But when I get home, anyway, y'all are here to eat supper. We're getting back on that subject now. You're here to eat supper. Is supper ready?
Just about, David.
Just about. Didn't I tell you they was coming, they'd be here?
No, you didn't.
Are you calling me a liar? You wouldn't do that.
No.
You better not ever do it.
No.
Go in there and get dinner ready. What a... Boy, I'll tell you. Oh, see, people just take advantage of you, man. You try to be nice to people, you know. You boys, I done told you now, get on out of here. Come on. Come on.
Come on, boys.
Get out of here.
Let's go.
Go play at the dog or something. Don't come back in either until I holler for you. Well, maybe we can get something done. You know, it's hard to let people come into my home because it's private. As you people know, I don't like many people at all. Everybody's saying that I'm crazy, everybody's saying that I'm goofy, everybody's saying that I'm not this and not that. Well, I don't care what you say about me. I give you a chance to come into my home to see how I live outside the ring. I guess you thought I'd be just like I was on television, always screaming and hollering and hurting people and stuff like that. Well, I can't do it here. I can't do it. Not that sometime I wouldn't want to. Oh, yeah. Yeah, let me tell you. Sometimes I just like them. But anyway, y'all are here to see. Anyway, you know, this house here is a very expensive house if you had it built. But the doctor's done everything that can be done. I've been all over the world. I stayed in the finest hotels all over. I rode the Concorde and put in to go in the space shuttle. And I built this house with these mamas right here. Oh yeah, every piece of it, all by myself. Didn't have no help from nobody, didn't need nobody. That's the reason I want you people to see that I'm just like everybody else. I got a wife, I got kids. But I don't let them run over me. And
honey,
this is my rela- I guess you thought I was through talking.
Excuse me, honey. Supper's ready.
Well, okay. Get the kids in. Bring them in here. Tell them get up there and wash your hands. Y'all come on in. We'll have something to eat here. She finally got it ready. I'm sorry about the delay there.
Wash your hands.
Y'all come on in here. Say, you boys get over here at the table. Sit down here. We'll get something to eat. Y'all sit down right there. Just something to eat here. Whoa! What in the world is wrong with you, woman? You move the table out there? What do you do that for? You out of your mind? Damn, you know what those cost? What is this, the city dump? Huh? You didn't have time. You didn't have a chance. Sit down. Sit down. Get something to eat. You ain't got time to do nothing. Boy, I... What is this?
It's pizza.
I can see it's pizza. I'm not a fool. You think you married a fool?
The kids
You're making a fool out of me what you're doing on national TV. Hey, I'm sorry. I told the woman to have something to eat fixed here for us to eat. I don't know what's wrong with her. Get up and get us something to eat or something. Do something. Don't just sit there like a goof or something. What are you smiling at? I'll slap that smile off your face. Don't smile at me, boy. Don't you laugh either. I mean it. Well, you're gonna eat or you're gonna stand there and stare at it. Eat it. Eat it now. Here, eat another piece of bread. Here, you eat a piece of bread. Here, you want another one? I'm sorry, I told y'all you come over, I invite you for supper. They put this out here, this goof here. I don't know what's wrong with you. Are you plumb out of your mind? Are you out of your mind? I'm talking to you, girl.
I just was fixing a little supper for the kids.
These ain't kids. These are TV people. You're out.
I wasn't expecting them, David.
Well, I told you they was coming.
It's
just go on. Get out of here. I don't even want you out here. I shouldn't even let you come down here out of the bedroom anyway. What are you looking at? No. You got a problem? No. Get upstairs. I don't want you down here either. Boy, this is ridiculous. I ain't never seen nothing. Hey, I don't know. Anyway, like I said, I'm like you people out there, man. I got wife, I got kids, I got problems. Only thing I know how to take. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Hand me that tea, boy. You ain't gonna drink it. I got problems, he's got problems. Everything. Oh! Oh, I'm gonna get you. Get up! Get up! Get up! Go! Get upstairs! When I get through, I'm gonna get you too. Get your brother too. I'm gonna get all of y'all. Hey, I tell you, I'm just upset, man. I don't know. I'm tired. I shouldn't invite you out here in the first place. It's a private home. Get your stuff up. Just get out, okay? Just get out. I'm tired of everything. I'm tired of the chicken and the pizza. Get out.
Yeah, y'all get on out of here. What's wrong with you? You crazy? Come out here and try to make a fool out of me. Get the camera out of here. Don't ever come back. I'm sick and tired of everybody and everything. Woman!
Dr. D. David Schultz and Dr. D. with his own special house call, I'd like to get your reaction to what we just saw, Lord Alfred Hayes.
I'd like to say that that was a sick person. I can't say that because I think everything he does is something for himself. It's intentional. I think what he actually does is he psychs himself up with his family. An unforgivable thing. And he does this with one purpose only, for the betterment of Dr. D. I think he really hurts his family so that he can make himself what he believes to be the greatest wrestler in the world, because he feels no pain. He said that. Mentally, I think what he does is he hurts his wife, he hurts his family, he hurts his children, he kicks his dog to make himself in such a thing. And I think that's just an awful, awful thing.
It would appear as though Dr. D. David Schultz practices the same intimidation at home as he does in the squared circle against opponents.
Well, I want to say I'm sorry for him. I can't say I'm sorry for him. He'll get his comeuppance.
Dr. D. David Schultz, however, we're going to have with us as our guest later on a totally different kind of person in Tito Santana.